Let's do your dance at the Space Jam.
Sometimes when you slow them down. And play. Stop and rewind. And stop. Let's slow it down some. And play. And stop and rewind. And stop. Let's slow it down just a little bit more. And play. Rewind. And stop. Shall I slow it down a little bit more?
Yes.
All right, and play.
Oh.
stop and rewind. And stop. Let's slow it down a little more and play. Stop and rewind. And stop. Let's slow it down a little bit more and play. And stop. And pause and play. And stop. And rewind. And one last time, and play. Skit is going to be real interesting. I just don't know what to say about it. I'm just going to let it happen. Here we go. Thank you.
time to sing and have an audience. My name is Hans.
And I'm Francine.
And we're here to pump
you up.
Oh, that's my personal trainer, Mr. Griffin. Francine.
I don't need a personal trainer.
You don't?
No, I don't.
Well, my personal trainer says you do need a trainer. Francine, how have you been?
I just had my protein shake. I'm ready.
Yeah, it just looks like you spilled some right here earlier, apparently, huh? It's all wet right here.
No, that's my sweat.
Sweat, okay. All right. My muscles are so big, I have to adjust them. So, Francine, you've been okay. I've been okay. Let me just say that I have been doing extra work on my pectoralis major and minor right here. I've been doing some extra work on those, and you probably noticed.
They're kind of tiny. Your pecs are kind of tiny. It's like doing yoga.
What? Yoga? I'll show you, Francine, what I do for my pecs. Watch this. That, Francine, is how you get huge pecs. Now, you on the other hand, I'm going to go from top to bottom. You have a pencil neck. And those legs are like spaghetti noodles.
What? These legs right here?
Yes. What do you do to work those things out?
I skip leg day. Want to see what I do?
Yeah, let's take a look. Are those supposed to be lunges?
Yeah.
Oh, Francine, that is so sad. That is so sad. That is so sad. I mean, look at the legs, pencil neck.
You're not being very HR squared.
Very what?
You're not being very
HR squared. HR squared? Who cares about it? HR squared? Francine, you don't even know how the world works. Francine, you may be right, but I'm still stronger than you. As a matter of fact, I bet you can't even lift my personal trainer again. I bet. Thank you. I bet, Francine, you cannot even lift this chair. Yeah, try it. Try it. I've been wanting to know if you can lift the chair, even just the chair. Oh. Well, Francine, I maybe I was wrong on that too. As a matter of fact, stay right like that, back face that way. You still have spaghetti noodle legs and pencil neck, but I'm noticing your abs very flat and bumpy in the right places, solid as a rock.
We build it up, build it up, build it up, and now it's solid. Solid as a rock.
Oh, Francine, that surprises me. But I'm still stronger, Francine, by far. Stand on the chair. I want to prove it to you again. Just stand on that chair. Very simple. Now be careful, because I know your spaghetti legs might crack. I'm going to pull you down on the count of three. On the count of three. One, two, three. Aha, I knew it. Pulled you down. I did not cheat. I counted, didn't I? You're making me go to my sweat rag again. Making me go to the sweat rag. You know, I don't like doing that. I'm going to count louder. One, two, three. Aha.
Well, you try to get on the chair. I can pull you down.
Oh, Okay, that's a deal. But let me make this point, Francine. When you're like me and you have muscles upon muscles, you must stretch them. That's what your problem was, spaghetti noodle legs. You must stretch them. Would you mind assisting me in this stretch?
Wait, I'm not
going to
help you do yoga.
I'm not, what? You mentioned yoga. I don't do yoga. Do you still think you can put me off the chair?
Yeah.
You still think?
Are you done stretching?
I'm going to get you for that, Francine. I'm just too tired now. All right, on the count of three. One, two, three. All right, Francine, I guessed it. I was wrong yet again. You know, I noticed something, though. When I pulled you down from the chair, you're going to challenge me yet again?
Yes. Stand on the chair and let's see if you can lift these 300 pounds of bleeding
oh.
Yeah.
Lifting you up, Francine, will be like in a balloon rising into the air. Very simple. Come here. The only thing heavy on you, Francine, is that chain. Come on, Francine, on the count of three. One, two, three. No, not really. All right, Francine, on the count of three. One, two, three. Francine. That was tough. Hey, did you notice, Francine, it was very easy to pull me down?
Yeah.
It was easier to pull you down.
It was easier to push you down, too.
Well, that's true. But when I try to pull you up, or lift you up, very difficult. Very difficult. Did you notice that? Do you think, Francine, it works that way in life sometimes? Well, take for instance our words. It's very easy to call you Polly. What? Spaghetti legs. Okay, let's not go there. Let's not do that. Yeah, basically. Yeah, it's easier to pull people down than to lift them up, even with our words.
You mean like compliment, lift people up?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, really
they are. They're not easy. Like I complimented your abdominis erectus.
Yeah. You have a really nice towel.
Yes, my sweat rag. Okay.
Yeah.
That's something that's attached to my person, but thank you very much. I'll take it. Hey, Hans, Francine, do you think?
I don't know.
Let's try it. Francine and I have a question for you on the count of three. One, two, three. What's the purpose of Bret Hart?
It's our swear, honesty, respect, responsibility.
I'm Hans.
And I'm Francine.
And we're here to pump
you up.
Yeah. All right. I just got a quick workout back there. Miss Dar is going to do Angry Pants for you. Then she's going to call for two volunteers. Some of you practiced that intermission. So let's see what we got. Skit for you, but I'm going to tell you we're running a little bit late. All right, so just bear with us. We got a couple more skits, so we're going to run a little bit late. All right, here we go.
Stop. Have a time.
This skit includes water. I've seen a couple of those. So enjoy.
Yes.
That is so gross. Oh, gross.
What?
It'll go online.
Oh, where?
All right, this next skit is called Johnny Got Hit by a Bike. I've hired these actors. I think they're pretty good. I want to see what you think. We're going to do hopefully just one take. We'll see how many takes we need to perfect it. Here we go. Johnny got hit by a bike. All right, here we go, actors. All right, here we go. Johnny got hit by a bike, and take one. Cut! Oh no! Hey, not bad, guys. Not bad.
That was awesome.
Hey, guys. Not bad, but I think we need to do a second take. I think we need a second. Well, it was good, but we need it great. I'm not paying you just to be good. All right? I get paid to be good. You guys are good for nothing. Sorry, guys. I'm still working on HR Squared. Hey, guys. I'm sorry. All right. I need it faster. Faster. And Johnny got hit by a bike. Take two. Slower.
What?
Take three. Johnny got hit by a bike. Take three. Slow it down.
Let's go.
Johnny got hit by a bike. Take three and action. Lacking. I need a little bit more emotion. A little bit more emotion. One last time. Here we go.
All right, you got emotion.
Johnny got hit by a bike. Take four and action. Come up and tell you the best advice they've ever received. The best advice they've ever received. Just little quick snippets. All right? Best advice I've ever received.
Okay. Well, I was in the Army, and one of my sergeants told me, we were paratroopers, and he said, if your main parachute doesn't open, you have the rest of your life to pull your reserve. That's a joke. My real piece of advice would be always tell the truth, and then you never have to remember what you have said.
The best advice I have ever received is from my mother, who told me that it's not important to be a perfect person, but it's important to be a good person. So it reminds me that it's okay to make mistakes.
I like that one.
Not from a parent, wizened elder, or palm reader, the best advice I've ever received is from a movie, one of my favorite movies, A Bronx Tale. In the film, Robert De Niro, the hardworking everyman character, imparts to his young son, an aspiring gangster, the saddest thing in life is wasted talent. And to me, that small phrase echoes throughout my life. With that, I'm reminded to continually aspire to be the best version of myself, strive to create a life of meaning and purpose, and lastly, pursue each opportunity that comes my way.
All right, it's hard to nail down like the best advice I've heard, but something that stuck with me is don't let the fear of failure keep you from trying. So this isn't something I'm normally comfortable with, but I jumped on board and got to come here and make new memories and have a lot of fun. So if I was afraid to do it and just didn't do it, I would have missed out on the fun here. So that kind of thing. Just make sure you get involved in something. Step up. Go for it.
This next skit is called the Doctor's Office Skit. Doctor's Office Skit.
Yes, he's with other patients right now. No, you know what?
I'll let him know that you're here. All right. Have a seat. Oh, God. Excuse me, but I'm going to need to see the doctor.
Let me guess, you're itching?
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Kind of bad. That's a good idea. How about you have a seat in the reception and waiting area?
Thank you.
Yeah, cool.
Just about done. We got one more thing to tickle your fancy with. Come on out, dancers. First, thanks for coming to Staff Stuff. It means a lot for us here to come. We raised some money. Give ourselves a hand. Good job. So here's what's going to happen. They're going to perform a dance for you two times. It's only a minute long. Then they're each going to come down and pick two audience volunteers. You want to come up and try the dance with them and the rest of the staff. You're going to be welcome to. Who thinks they might come up? All right, quickly. There's a meaning to this dance. There's a meaning to this dance. You're going to hear the word Eddie, E-D-D-I-E. Each day, determine it early. So each day you wake up, it's going to be your choice if you determine to live honestly, respectfully, and responsibly. What's the purpose of Bret Hart? So they're going to do this dance two times, then I'll come down and get an honest volunteer, and we'll be done. And again, thank you for coming. All right, Julian, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Audience volunteers and the rest of the staff will join after as well. All right, one more time. Remember, this whole song's about Eddie. Each day, determine it early. It's your choice whether you be honest, respectful, and responsible. No one's going to make you do that. You make a conscious decision. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Stand by me. Stand by me.
Okay, Eddie. This one's for you.
Two audience volunteers apiece.
Oh,
All right. Here we go. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Okay. Oh my God.